Hi everyone. Today's video is going to be about an art piece that I called Alignment. Bear with me, this is my first video. The sketch on this, oh my god, it took me literally three different sketches to come up with this, and me like twisting and turning at night, like before bed, trying to think, how do I want to have this be? And it was like at a time where I was having kidney problems. Like I had a kidney stone and, you know, a couple of infections, and it was right before Thanksgiving. And of course, like, I couldn't see a doctor because of everything that's going on in 2020. Obviously, everyone's backed up and stuff. So I had to go to urgent care, and around that time when I was making this art piece, and I just felt so, like, I had gone from being a super healthy person to a super not healthy person, like in a wheelchair, bad health, to being what I am now, where I'm able to pretty much live a normal life. And then, like, every time I get sick, it just freaks me out every time. And so with this piece, I was feeling really like stretched, but like I kept getting like these spiritual messages about like the duality of life, like the good versus the not so good. And it was interesting because like I kept having this like thought, like, well, if the, you know, I just kept seeing like the yin yang symbol, and I kept seeing like, okay, well, with the dark and then with the light, you know, what is it that's pushing like right in the middle? And so I was thinking, okay, rainbow, you know, like white is the white light or whatever is basically all color, right? And then the dark is like devoid of color. But if you're in space, you know, like stars are what give, you know, outer space, like, its beauty, right? And there's a lot of beauty in the darkness. So that's kind of where this concept came from. It was, I used my own, like, body as a reference. I had my boyfriend take a picture of me while I'm, like, standing outside, like, reaching like this. I'll put a picture in the video. And it just took me literally like hours and hours of sketching. I don't know if it's because it's been so long that I, you know, have done art. Probably has. Because I hadn't done art because I have arthritis and my hands really bother me sometimes. So I have to take breaks, and it's been a couple of years since I've been able to really have dexterity in my hands and it be okay. And so it's like relearning, reteaching myself how to have, you know, super fine technical skills with my, you know, sketching and stuff, which I used to love to do. So anyways, I had to do a couple of different sketches for this and took way longer than it really should have. So what I did is I did sketches, and then I took a picture on my iPad, and then I sketched it out, or I did some line art. And at first she was going to be like a white woman or whatever, but I got really bored with that, and I just felt like, I don't know, like darker skin, like the richness of it, and like adding some golden tones would be better for this piece. And I was really super focused on trying to make it just try and stand out against the yin yang like kind of background or whatever, you know. And I feel like a lot of the lighting came out a lot better because I did darker skin, and just I don't know. There was something so gorgeous about having it a rich color like that. And then I've been really like focused on green eyes lately for some reason. I think, you know, green is like the color of the heart chakra. So like love and everything. And the eyes are the windows to the soul, right? So I really focused on trying to have like bright, vibrant green eyes. The coloring took a little bit longer than I would have liked, but again, it's been a while since I've done art. And then I did like storm colored hair, you know, like from X-Men. Storm was one of my favorites. I mean, other than Rogue, I actually had like two Rogue, you know, blonde pieces when I was in middle and high school. And because she's kind of like in space, you know, in this piece. So I really wanted her hair to look gorgeous and stuff, to go with like the rest of her attitude in this art piece. And then the rainbow itself was interesting because I didn't really know, like I felt, like I said, stretched in this like my feeling for this art piece, hence like the broken up pieces and stuff. And right in the middle is like a void, you know, kinda, is how I had originally felt. But I pretty much just kinda, I didn't really know what to do with it there. And then I ended up in really enjoying doing like the stars of this piece. That was really fun. And I just added the black and white lines because I just wanted to make it look a little bit more, I don't know, put together, because with her just sitting there, it seemed like there wasn't really much context, so that's why I added the black and white there. So that was the process with this art piece. I hope you guys enjoyed. And the reason why I called it an alignment is because I feel like even when, you know, we have that polarity of the dark and the light, the yin yang, female, male, whatever, when we're balanced and stuff, we're in alignment with our life purpose. That's when we're happiest, that's when we're peaceful. And that's really kind of what I wanted to be feeling, because with all the illness stuff that was coming back and kind of giving me a little bit of PTSD, that's what I was wanting at the time of first creating this piece. And I actually had to recreate it a second time. I had made it on the iPad and it looked totally different. I'll put a picture of what that looked like too. So yeah, thanks for listening, you guys. I hope you're having a good day, and I'll see you in the next video.